Hello, my name is Bas Konijnsluiper. I am from the Netherlands, and I'm a collector of vintage computers like MSX and Videopac. Now I want to show you how to change a keyboard from a Commodore for using it on a Philips music module. But first, I want to explain you some MSX audio devices. First, I want to show you some different audio devices for MSX computers. This is the first one, the Yamaha FM Sound Synthesizer Unit. It's special made for Yamaha music computers, but with a special adapter, you can use it on every MSX computer. On this cartridge, you will find MIDI and a special keyboard connector. Yamaha has some different keyboards you can use on this special cartridge. The next one is the Toshiba FM Synthesizer Unit, also known as the Toshiba Music Module. The package contains this cartridge and the keyboard. The keyboard you can plug in this cartridge. The next one is the latest version of the audio device. This is the Audio Wave, and it's based on the cartridge from Toshiba and Panasonic. It is also a keyboard connector. You can use the Toshiba and Yamaha keyboards on this cartridge. The next one is the Panasonic MSX Audio. Panasonic has also its own keyboard, but is also compatible with Yamaha and Toshiba keyboards. And the last one is the Philips Music Module, the Philips MSX Audio. This comes with MIDI and also a keyboard connector. But this one, it looks the same, but for Philips you need a special keyboard. The other keyboards from Yamaha and Toshiba are not working on this cartridge. Here I have the smallest keyboard from Yamaha, the 01. This one is compatible with Yamaha cartridges, Toshiba, Panasonic and the Audio Wave. The next one is the Yamaha 10, a big one. This one is also compatible with Toshiba, Panasonic, Audio Wave and Yamaha cartridges. We have another one from Yamaha, the 20, the 20. This one is also compatible with the Audio Wave, Panasonic, Toshiba en Yamaha cartridges. Then I have here, and it's very heavy, the Toshiba keyboard. This one is of course compatible with the Toshiba audio, the Audio Wave, the Panasonic en de Yamaha cartridge. Here I have an original Philips. This one is only compatible with the Philips MSX Audio. And the last one, a very special one. And this one looks almost the same as the Philips one, but has a different connector. This is a Commodore music keyboard. And it's made for Commodore computers. When I have shown you all different types of audio devices for the MSX, the working of it, then I will show you how to change this keyboard for a Philips music module. This one is more common than the Philips module and more cheaper. It's very easy to change because it's almost the same as the Philips. Let's start with the Toshiba MSX audio cartridge. Normally, the internal program is starting automatically, but I changed the ROM. So when I use the escape button during booting the computer, the program starts. Please look at the intro screen. You will see Toshiba 1985 Toshiba Corporation. This is the internal program, and if you want to play some music, you have to connect the keyboard to this cartridge. It's not possible to play with the keys on the keyboard from the computer. You can only listen to the pre-programmed music. It is also possible to start the program with a call command. Call SYN. And then the program starts. Now I've connected the Panasonic MSX Audio. This program is original, so when you put in the cartridge in the computer, the program starts automatically. Look at this intro screen. It starts with MSX Music System. And it looks like the Toshiba. Same music, a little bit louder. But you can play together. You can play with the keyboard, or you can play with the keyboard from the computer. That's a big difference. When I start up the computer with escape, the computer starts in basic. And also with call SYN, I will start the internal program of this big cartridge. The next one is the MSX Audio cartridge Audio Wave from Brazil. The program does not start automatically. Also does not start with escape. In basic you have to type call Synte. Then the program starts just like the Panasonic Audio. You can play the music. You can play with the keyboard from the computer or with an external keyboard. The last one I want to show you is the Philips MSX Audio, the music module. I changed this cartridge, so with the escape button I will start the internal program. With the stop key I will stop the music, and when I start with start gling, the music starts again and I can play with a computer keyboard. When I want to play with an external keyboard, the Philips external keyboard, there is here a function, and here I can put on the keyboard in the on position and I can play with a keyboard. When you are in BASIC, it's also possible to start the internal program. Call music box. Here I have the original cable from the Commodore keyboard. This is the connector. And here I have a connector that fits in the Philips MSX audio cartridge. It's a little bit bigger. So first, cut off the old connector. And then we have to press this connector on the right way on this cable. I have pressed this too small cable in this connector. Be careful. The red wire is on this side, is normally pin 1, but not in this case. You will find pin 1 of the connector here on this side with a little arrow. You have to push the cable to the left side. So the pins against the red wire are not used. If you squeeze it on this way, it should have to work. Here you can see how it looks like when you see the top of this connector. The red wire on this side. Now I can cut off a little piece of the wire. This is the complete job, an easier to find keyboard for a lower price. Let's test this keyboard. I will start up the internal program. It's a Hungarian music. Jonapot Magyarország. I speak a little bit Hungarian. I stop the music, I go to keyboard on, and I can play. And more than that, I cannot play on a piano. Let's start the Hungarian music again. Thank you for watching this video, Commodore meets MSX. And special for my Hungarian followers, Viszont Latásra, Magyarország. See you next time in a new video.